Good morning students. Today I am going to teach you mathematics for 11th standard. Chapter 1 Sets, Relations and Functions. Let us see exercise 1.2 first sum. Discuss the following relations for reflexivity, symmetricity and transitivity. First subdivision. The relation are defined on the set of all positive integers by the rule m related to n if m divides n. Write the rule here. If m divides n, then we can say m is related to n. This is the rule. First, check for reflexivity. What is the definition for reflexive relation? M is related to m itself. Since m divides m, that is, every number divides itself, this is true for all positive integer. Therefore, we can say m is related to m. Hence, R is reflexive. Here, R represents relation. Next is symmetricity. What is the definition? M is related to n implies n is related to m. For example, I am considering 2 and 4 here. 2 divides 4, but the answer is not equal to 4 divides 2. Here also we are talking about only the positive integers. 4 divides 2, the answer will be in fraction. So here their answers are not equal. So we can tell m related to n does not imply n related to m. Therefore, R is not symmetric here. Transitivity, what is the definition? M related to n and n related to p implies m related to p. Let us check here. Since m divides n and n divides p, then we can say m divides the third element p. For example, I am considering three elements, three positive integers, 2, 4 and 8. Here we can say 2 divides 4 and 4 divides 8. From this, we can able to write 2 divides 8, the third element. So this is the example. From this example, we can write m related to n and n related to p implies m is related to p. Hence, we can say R is transitive. Therefore, R is reflexive, not symmetric and transitive. Second subdivision. Let P denote the set of all straight lines in a plane. The relation R defined by L is related to M if L is perpendicular to M. Whenever two lines are perpendicular, then we can say L is related to M. For that, we have to take three elements from the set P, where P contains the set of all straight lines. First, reflexivity. The definition is L related to L. Since any line cannot be perpendicular to itself, that is here I am considering the line L. L is not perpendicular to L itself, that is L is not related to L. This implies the relation R is not reflexive. Symmetricity, the definition is L related to M implies M related to L. See the diagram. L is any line and M is another line. Here these two lines are perpendicular. So L is perpendicular to M. Also we can say M is perpendicular to L. So both sides are true. Therefore we can write L is related to M implies M is related to L. Hence, R is symmetric. Next, transitive. The definition is L related to M and M related to N implies L related to N. Let us start our discussion here. If L is perpendicular to M, see the diagram. Here L is perpendicular to M. And M is perpendicular to N, some other line. But these two lines are not perpendicular. Therefore, here L related to M and M related to N by the word perpendicular, but L is not perpendicular to N, therefore we can write L is not related to N. Therefore, R is not transitive. Hence, the relation is only symmetric. Thank you.